All right, what's up, guys? So we're doing a CV axle today, but we're out here and it's pouring rain. We're at a RV campsite we got for pretty cheap out here in Texas. So to get to the truck to access it, I'm whittling tent spikes to spike this tarp down to keep us dry, because we don't want to get our stuff all wet. It will make a hard job harder. So what I did is I whittled this peg with little tie lines. We're gonna tie some paracord here and tie it up in a second. All right, what's up, guys? Back. We're doing a CV axle. They're all pretty much the same. It doesn't matter what your vehicle is, if it's a car, van, or truck. That's the CV down there I'm videotaping. We're gonna remove that. See how the rubber's separating? Here, let me see if I can point it. See how this is separated? It's broken. Popped it. So we're gonna take that off. Let me get the... Here we are. Here's a CV. Here's your boot. There's our busted boot. We just did, it's the second one we've done in 3 or 4 days. It's gone bad. Usually, the other side was way worse than this side is currently. Praise God we caught it in time. So we're gonna put a new axle on here. So see, the axle connects to your rotor. So next we're gonna take this pin out, Carter pin out, and then 32 inch socket for your nut. I got a new one of these. Now, we gotta get these 6 bolts back here that are a pain. I've already sprayed some blaster, spray a little more.
What is that?
PB blaster. Stuff's amazing. Penetrating spray. Now I just gotta find the right size for these.
And then the black sockets, why do you use those?
Because they're the deep impact ones. They sell them for like 11 bucks at Walmart. Because if I use a regular socket for what I'm doing right now, it would break. You know what I mean?
So the regular silver ones aren't as strong as these black high impact ones?
Yeah, high impact. Because this is high impact stuff we're doing here. Dang, that's not the right size. Dang, it's starting to rain, huh? Go figure. That's not the right size. That's the right size.
What size is it?
It's 9/16. Let me just try a half inch just to see. Nah, don't fit. 9/16. I think it's actually metric, so it'd be a 14, but I don't have a 14 millimeter deep impact. So you don't want to do them by hand. You want to take an impact wrench.
And because it's in such an awkward position,
so
it's
awkward.
It's easier to... That wasn't loud.
Man, I wish this rain would just let up just for a hair.
But you put up this cool tarp, so that's not so bad, right?
Yeah, hey, it could be worse. It could always be worse. Praise the Lord. All right, so when you're doing your CV axle, you just got to disconnect your CV axle from your front differential. That's what we're doing right now. With this one off.
Three down, three to go.
This is the only really loud part anyway.
Yeah, the rest, we just remember maneuvering that CV axle. Mm-hmm. And it's going to be a pain, hopefully mm-hmm. not. It was last time though. Dang, this rubber boot's gone, dude. Good thing we're doing this now. There's that one. One more.
One more, yay. Super loud. We're at a campsite. Did you tell them?
Yeah. RV park. People are here on vacation. And here we are doing like the man garage.
Yay.
Last one.
Oh. Ooh, it just kind of fell.
All right, let's get it out and get the new one in.
Cool.
So remember last time I had to pound on it a little bit.
Oh, yeah, on the this bowl right here.
Here, get that rubber mallet. Here. Put PB Blaster in here and very loudly bang it up with this metal hammer. I'm sure our neighbors are quite satisfied with that. Dang, that sucker's in there, dude. Oh man, the whole bottom fell off the axle. Okay, that thing was so broken, the whole bottom just fell off.
What the?
That was about to happen to us on the road, dude.
Wow. Praise God.
Look at that, it broke.
Praise God he gave you the wisdom and the incentive just to do it.
Dude, I knew we had to get it done today. There it goes. Okay, let me get this out.
So it's really difficult to get out, yeah, but it's doable.
It's a pain. We've done it once before.
Like 3 days ago. 4 days ago.
It's not out yet. How would you wiggle this?
Here we go. You got it, Bippy.
Oh, leaking grease everywhere, dude.
Oh, whoa.
Help me out. Crazy. Turn the camera off and help me out. We got a video how bad it was.
I Look at that, guys. Like how terrible that was.
Can you believe that? Dude, imagine if that would have happened on the road. I'm telling you, the Lord told me to get this done today. After I knew it broke, because it broke the other day, I was driving and it went clonk, clonk.
But did you just say many of the afflictions of the righteous, but Psalm 34,
the Lord? The Lord delivers them from each one. So, let's compare to make sure we got the right part. Always compare to make sure you got the right part before you install it.
Tell them yesterday at the store how you were...
Okay.
Why are you whispering, baby?
Dude, we're at a campsite, people on vacation, we're out here banging and
no
drilling.
One can hear us talking over that hammering.
So we were at the store to buy this. The kid was new, and he brought one out in the same box. But the part number didn't match up, and I took a look at it, and see that nut right there? That was only this big. And I was like, bro, that ain't the right piece for my truck.
It didn't match up?
Didn't match up.
So you double-checked before you left.
Oh wow, this one came with a new carter pin.
Ooh, nice. I wonder if the other one did too.
Didn't. If it did, we lost it. Had to buy carter pins. Whoa.
So it had
brown stuff in
hey
here.
You guys, it does have the zip tie on it. Uh-huh. And we were worried about it first taking it off, but it was fine. Baby, can we put this old one in the box?
Yeah, hold on.
Okay, so don't be nervous to cut that zip tie. Okay.
Very carefully. I'm going to set this here so we don't destroy the new one. Now the old one. Man, I don't know why there's like rust on it.
Alright guys, we'll be back in a minute.
Cut off. Take your CV axle. Now is the hardest part of this whole thing. There's like a certain way. Because you don't want to damage the new boots. You know what I'm saying? Lord, give us favor in Jesus' mighty name. Oh my gosh.
Wow.
Not in
the Lord. Almost though.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, it's in.
Wow. Now, good job, baby.
Now dude, that was way easier than last time.
Hey guys, check this out. We looked it up online. It's $1,100 to do.
To do that, what we're doing
right
now.
A mechanic.
I paid $100 for this.
$112
for for a brand new CV axle.
So you guys, you can do this kind of stuff at home.
Like, dude, they want you to waste money. Dang, look at the bearings fell out.
Is that what that was? I thought they were globs of grease.
No, baby, those are bearing balls. If that would have happened on the road, we'd be in so much trouble. That's like, that could have killed somebody. That's the second time in a week that something that could have killed somebody happened to our truck. Remember we had broken lug studs last week?
That was crazy.
So these are lug studs, and we had them break.
A right? Snap, one snap.
Like, snap that off. But to get a new one in, you gotta get way back here behind everything, pop it out, and then figure out how to maneuver another one in past the brake system.
That was crazy.
That was crazy. I wish you would have started the channel with that one. Right? Is that the security guy?
We're about to find out, huh? If so, we'll get on video.
That's it?
I don't think so.
Is he grilling us?
I don't know. I don't think so.
Okay. Hold on, I gotta get these bolts.
I mean, obviously, we're doing this because we need to, not because we're like...
Yeah, we're stuck.
Do the song.
Okay, there's one bolt.
Okay.
Lug stud. Now,
so you just take the old bolts.
We do bolt by bolt.
The old bolts.
Now, when you put bolts in, always hand thread them first, because if you do it diagonal, and then you, like, say, I was just, like, took this and, like, cranked it in there, and it wasn't lined up, I would strip that whole thing out and ruin it.
Right.
Bolt will break. If you do them all hand tight. See what I'm saying? So I'm just putting it in nice and hand.
That's what you're saying.
That
was insane.
I didn't think it was that far along. We need a new rotor. But it was actually way farther than I thought, dude. I didn't think it was that bad.
So again, what he's doing is he's finding a good angle to put in the bolts. And then
I can't access it like from the other side, but I can access it through this hole right here. So you're showing the hole I'm utilizing. So here's a straight line of shot. So I'm accessing it through here to get all these bolts hand tight.
And then what he does after each one...
I'm going to turn the whole rotor, and it cranks the CV, and then it lines me up in a clear line of sight. Like that. Two CV axles in 3 days. You tell me that not everything's spiritual warfare, and dude, I'm telling you, you do what we do, this kind of stuff happens, yo.
I mean, maybe it's not spiritual warfare for everybody, but...
Look what we just did in San Antonio. We got a broken CV axle going into San Antonio and a broken CV axle coming out of San Antonio. You tell me that's not a principality or something?
And for those of you who are new to the channel...
Well, this is a new channel. This is the
Tell them what we did going in to San Antonio.
What do we do?
Well, what we like to do is go in and share the gospel of Jesus Christ. Mainly with the lost, the broken, the homeless...
The desperate, the broken.
And why do we do that?
Because we're supposed to preach the gospel to all. But I was homeless for 17 years, so I know how it is. It sucks. Okay, ready? Now I'm gonna crank these suckers.
Cool.
Last time I'm gonna use this wrench, or no, second to last time.
Cinco. Remember that one mechanic in Hiawassee?
Which one? Put the wire on the pedal.
I reckon I can...
Want us to fall off when we're driving? One more.
Because it's like so embarrassing right now, guys. Which I normally don't care, but.
Lisa's always telling me, don't care what people think about you. And then, yeah, here we are.
Well, there's this one mechanic in Hiawassee, guys, when we were trying to through our break box, and he's like, I reckon I can see you sometime after lunch.
In a week. All right, now, wheel nut, okay? Wheel nut's crucial. It's a 32-inch. If you're doing a CV axle on a truck, you got to go buy a 32-inch socket.
That's a big socket, too, guys. I was like, what the?
It's like $9. I mean, you can get a cheap one for like $4. But if you got to get it, just get the right one. Deep socket so you don't break it, because this is your wheel. If your wheel falls off, you're dead, dude. So get a good socket so your wheel don't fall off.
And we get it. We're like always on a really cheap. Like
we're on
tight
a huge budget.
But sometimes if you go too cheap, it's just trash. So.
All right, so we take our socket and we're going to pump it on there. This is the last time I'm going to use it.
Okay? Mm-hmm.
Done.
Yay.
Now we take our cotter pin.
Oh, yeah, this is important, guys. Check this out.
We're going to seal it. Yeah, I should probably drive it on there a little bit more just to be safe.
No, I think that makes that noise because it can't go anymore.
I don't want these coming off when I can't.
Babe, I really don't think it's going to move at all.
It just did. It just moved like 2 inches.
So tell how you do the cotter pin. You
put it through
both
the hole to the butt here.
Both of the parts of the pin.
But you want to push it back a little bit.
And then...
peel one way, or you can do them both the same way, I guess. Doesn't really matter as long as you bend them. Let me get that hammer.
Hammer time.
Stop. Hammer time.
Anyways, you have to.
I will.
That's another thing. Don't trust a,
you get the torque.
What do you call this? An air gun?
Yeah.
Don't trust it when you're, doing your tires. You always want to do it by hand too, because we made that mistake. Where were we? In New Hampshire, and we made that mistake, and then our wheel almost fell off.
Wheel, like we were driving down the highway and the lug nuts started loosening, so we didn't measure our torque. And you got 100 pounds torque for your lug nuts whenever you take a tire off.
We didn't know that at the time.
Every time you take a tire off, you gotta make sure you got 100 pounds torque going back on. So here's our torque wrench. We'll set it. Set.
Well, how do you do that? I've always wondered what you meant by like 100 pounds.
See, the 100 has a line that goes to there, and then we bring this line to that line. Oh. So actually, we're at 80. We gotta bring it up. All right. Now we're at 100 pounds torque. That's 100 pounds. So now I'm gonna check each one by hand. I gotta lower it to do this. Yeah. I forgot.
Babe, I'm so impressed how quick you did that.
Yeah. Like 20 minutes.
See, you got that it so
like
good. Got it so good because even through all these trials and tribulations, guess what, guys?
Pull,
we learned a lot.
Pull that jack stand.
Oh, yeah. Hang on, guys. So what you had?
Emergency jack stand.
See, I help. Okay.
Yeah,
you use that little jack?
Yeah.
Dang, bro.
That's why I was a little worried.
Hmm.
Well, guess what? That little jack is rated at 4 tons, and our big jack's only 2 tons.
Oh, that's silly.
That's why I use the little jack for the trailer.
There
all right,
you go.
100 pounds.
Yes, sir.
Hear a break like that? Mm-hmm. That means it's clicking at 100. That one's good. Thing. The other ones. That one's good.
Oh, we should have done that video yesterday with Christy's car.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, we did Christy's car yesterday. There, that's it.
Baby, I think you missed one. The very top one, though?
Yeah, I got it.
Yeah, that's the one you missed.
Yeah, it's good.
Oh, okay, good. My bad.
We're at 100. All right, let's clean up this mess. We're done.
All right. You want to close this out?
All right. All this information is totally useless if you don't have Jesus Christ in your life. So surrender everything to Jesus. He'll direct your steps and bless you and guide you. So I pray this is a blessing. If you have any questions, leave them below. This has been a CV axle replacement. If you have a specific vehicle you're struggling with, let me know the year, make, model, and the problem you're having, and I'll see if I can't help you figure it out. In Jesus' name, bye.